everyone. My name is Kaopathic, and this is my trophy guide for Final Fantasy X HD. I'm currently going through the Bevelle Cloister of Trials, which requires you to get the Destruction Sphere item for the trophy Feel the Pain. Now, right here at the Bevelle Cloister, you're going to want to push this pedestal onto this area. A thing to know about this Cloister of Trials is it's very much on rails, and you have to kind of control how it moves. By just, there'll be glyphs on the ground, and they'll have arrows pointing different directions. Some of them you're able to stop at, some of them you simply roll over, and you're going to have to hit circle or X, game version depending, to tell it which way you want to go. Right here at the start, you're going to want to turn right to go down to the second level. As you may notice, the second level doesn't really have much going for it, so you just keep going straight. And this will put you on the third level. Once you're down here, you go ahead and grab that Bevelle Sphere, and you're going to want to put it on the pedestal. You cannot have a spear in your hand and move, and there always must be one Bevelle Sphere on the pedestal for it to move, so keep that in mind. And a quick thing I'd like to go over, well, you're going to want to go back up to the first level where you started, but one thing I'd like to go over, first of all, is it's actually impossible to miss the Destruction Sphere and its item in this dungeon, but there is an alternate secret item, and so I'm going to be doing that as well. Other than that, I'd like this video to be useful, as the Bevelle Temple is really annoying, as you don't really get to control your movements that well. But now that you're back on the first level, go forward, and when the arrow is pointing to the right, you're going to want to hit circle or X there to get on this little area. And you're going to want to take one of those Bevelle Spheres off the pedestal, and you're going to want to put it in the slot there on the wall. This will actually open up a new area on the second level, the one that was just pointing one direction, and let you down to the third. But before you go down there, you're going to have to get to the other little area right across from where you are here. But since every time you step on, you automatically keep moving, you can either turn around here or let yourself fall off the ledge and start at the beginning. Either way, just make sure you get to the other area, not the one that you went at before. You're going to want to grab that Bevelle Sphere from the lip. And of course you're going to want to put it on the pedestal. And once it's on the pedestal, of course, just push it back onto the rails. This will have you go towards the edge again, and you can either turn around or just let yourself fall off. It doesn't really matter. Once you get back to where you started, you're going to want to turn right again and go down to the second level, which will now have three directions. You'll have left, forward, and back. You're going to want to turn left, as there's a lot to do on this level of the cloister. Now this level also has three glyphs, and one thing you'll notice about launching from that glyph specifically, you actually move very fast, and you can actually overshoot a glyph, so it may take a few tries, but it shouldn't be that difficult. And don't worry if you fall off the ledge, because, you know, you may fall, but you're just going to restart. So hit the last glyph, and then take one of the Bevelle Spheres and put it on that lip. And that's going to open up a walkway, which leads to an area you can't access yet, so go ahead and push the pedestal back onto the railway. And this is automatically going to throw you over the ledge, but don't worry, as I said, you just start back at the beginning of this layer. And now, if that part done, you're going to want to shoot for the right turn on the second glyph on the floor. As I said, you actually move pretty fast when you launch from that glyph, and so you can overshoot it. a thing to note about when you're trying to go for the glyphs is as long as you're somewhat inside the little gray box that the perimeter around the glyphs is, you can actually activate the glyph. So it doesn't have to be exact, but you have to be within its little area of operation. And here, it took me 3 tries because I was just moving too fast, unfortunately. Go ahead, and once you get in on the second glyph, you get onto the ground here. You're going to want to grab that sphere glyph, or glyph sphere. You grab the glyph sphere from the lip there. Go ahead and put it on your pedestal. And then, of course, you're going to want to push your pedestal back onto the railway. And before you go over the ledge, you're going to want to take the turn at the third glyph. And since you're moving a lot slower, be sure not to miss it. Should be really easy. And now that you're here, go ahead and take the glyph sphere. And you're going to want to put that in that little socket in the design right there. That opens up this area, which is the destruction sphere. So go ahead and take that. Since you can't carry it, of course you're going to need to put it on the pedestal. And you're going to want to push the pedestal back onto the railway. And of course the pedestal is going to go over the ledge. And it's going to have you restart back at the beginning of this layer. Now that you're back here again, you're going to want to go back to the second glyph. And now that you're here, you're going to take that destruction sphere, and you're going to put that in the little socket there on the wall. And this actually opens up the end of the level. And as I said, it's impossible to miss, but there is an additional item, so we're going to get that. So there's one more thing to do here. Push the pedestal back onto the railway, and you're going to want to go back to where the third glyph led to again. It's a real popular area here in Bevelle Temple. And you're going to want to take that Bevelle sphere and put that Bevelle sphere on the pedestal there. This is important because if you do not do this part, you will not be able to get the additional item. Put your pedestal back there. Step on it. You're going to get thrown over the edge, and you're going to start at the beginning again. A lot of repeating here. Now, you're going to want to shoot for the first glyph turn. If you overshoot it, don't worry, you can just try again over and over. Either way, get that right-hand turn at the first glyph. This is going to lead you to a little area. There's nothing to do here, so just go ahead and just push the... No idea what I was doing there. Push the pedestal onto the second railway area. If the destruction sphere wasn't in its proper place, this would just lead to a dead end and you'd go back. But with the destruction sphere in place, it leads you up to a new area. And here you are. You actually have a bit more ground. Go ahead and go past the pedestal. And when you approach the right, you will automatically open up the chest, which is the destruction sphere. So there you have it. Now for that additional item, you want to step on that little glyph there. Take one of the Bevelle spheres, put it in that socket on the wall, and that activates that little railway there. And you can go ahead and push that pedestal over there to get the item. Everything is automatic. And this was the Bevelle Cloister Trials. For an in-depth trophy guide, you can go to PlayStationTrophies.org for all trophy-related information on this game. Thank you all for watching. Have a good day, and I hope to see you in the next video.